Hi, everybody. I'm Rick Kogan of the Chicago Tribune. I have read in my life 20,000 short stories. Among the best that I've ever read is Erika Schmidt's most recent story. She's the winner of the latest Nelson Algren Award. I used to drink with Nelson, so that gives me some credibility here. I couldn't be more pleased for you.
Thank you.
How did you find out, before we figure out how you gave a submission, how did you find out? What was that moment like for you?
Very surreal. I'm sure that's a common response. But I was in a studio sublet in San Francisco, having just moved there, didn't have an apartment yet or a job. I was watching Downton Abbey and packing to move into our apartment the next day. And I got the call that way.
Who called you?
Elizabeth Taylor called me. And she actually emailed me first to say, can I have your phone number because I don't know who you are and I need to talk to you about this contest. And I thought, wow, I wonder if, like, they must think
did
I plagiarized
I not have,
it
wait,
or
did
something.
Did I not have enough postage in the envelope or something?
Well, I think they only have your email address. I don't know. But so I gave her my number and she called. And I really, that email to me did not mean
exactly.
Anything.
Sure.
And then she called me and told me, and was completely out of the blue, just totally bizarre and shocking.
You know, Erika, what a difficult contest this thing is to win. They must have hundreds, if not thousands, of submissions. So it generally, did you think of it as this is a sort of literary crapshoot?
When I entered?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I really wasn't even thinking that far ahead. I was thinking, I'd been working on a few stories for a long time and kind of the goal was to just get through one process and really dig into revising and understand more what that meant. And this was one of those stories and the one that I felt best represented where I am or where I was at that point.
Why did I send it in?
I really wanted to practice submitting. I mean, I was more in that state when I submitted it to this.
Talk to me about the form itself. Short story writing, you know, some of my gods of short story writing are John Cheever and John O'Hara and Irwin Shaw. Short story writing seems to have gone slightly out of fashion these days. It's hard enough to get any kind of book published. Mm-hmm. But a short story is, there's just the market isn't there.
Yeah.
What appeals to you about that form?
Well, I've always read fiction, and that's through my whole life of wanting to be an actor and really putting almost all of my effort into that. I still was always reading fiction. And over the last few years, I finally started to acknowledge that fact and kind of get back in touch with what I really want to do, how I want to spend my energy.
Were you reading short fiction?
Both.
Yeah.
But I think, I mean, really more so longer form. And I think I'm probably moving toward more long form.
There's a novel coming, ladies and gentlemen. That means there's a novel coming.
In fact, here it is.
Here, Rick. Stop putting it in the Tribune. Who are some of your heroes and influences?
Well, right now, one of my favorite writers is Jennifer Egan.
Mm-hmm.
I love her stuff. And that's kind of a newer one. She has a short story from a couple years ago called Black Box that just kind of blew my mind that I really loved. And I was working on this story somewhere around that time, and I felt like one of the things I love about her writing in that story in particular is just being free with what the form of the story is. So you've got a subject matter that's really important to you and that you're connected to is most resonant. And once that job is done, being able to loosen up in terms of how you're expressing it.
What's the title of the winning short story?
Of hers?
Yours.
Of mine is Story About a Family.
What's the story?
It covers a family of four, a young family going through a divorce, and it covers a long span of time from the time that the kids are, you know, preschool, toddler and preschool age up until when they're grown up.
See, this is one of the things that distinguishes it that I was kind of overwhelmed by. Very few, I mean, many, many great short stories or short stories that take place in a day. I think of Irwin Shaw's The Women in Their Summer Dresses. Girl, I guess, but that's one of the things that really overwhelmed me about your story is that you dealt with this huge amount of time. Was that a challenge for you? You certainly set yourself up for a big challenge. You must have known that when you said, hey, I'm going to cover all these years.
Well, I wanted to cover the family, and so I wasn't thinking about it in terms of time as much. And also, what I was focusing on were a series of small moments.
Yeah.
So it didn't ever feel overwhelming in that way, where you have set up this big picture this end goal and you don't know how you're going to get there. I really allowed myself to take as long as I wanted to with the story and just kind of collect these, hoard the little moments and focus on them one at a time. And then I did a lot of rearranging and throwing out, and like there's a ton of stuff I didn't use.
Had you entered any contests before, any literary contests before this?
No.
First time's a charm.
This is the first time, yeah. So, for better or worse.
Well, no, that's setting the bar pretty high.
Yeah.
Once Liz had called and you realized that you were going to join this, what I think is an incredibly distinguished group of writers, including one of my gods, Stuart Dybeck, did you feel the weight of this win?
Yeah, it's definitely like, it's telling you that you are now, you have to take yourself seriously, and this is the pursuit that you've chosen, and you can't minimize it, which is a good thing. That's a really good thing, and it's something that you try to cultivate on your own, but something from the outside like this.
Well, obviously, at the time you won, you were still working on many other things. Is that moment, does it become surreal, or does it become really empowering?
Both, definitely both. Yeah, I'd say at first it's mostly surreal. And it's just been really meaningful to me in terms of my immediate feeling was, okay, this is great, now I need to keep working. I mean, we were in this crazy time. I just moved. I literally don't have a job or a house, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I was up the night before worrying about writing. Should I keep doing this? That kind of thing. And this is the type of, like, tangible that you can, that kind of galvanizes you.
And it's also a real milepost that all of a sudden there's a road.
Yeah.
As indistinct as it might be in
the
future.
Exactly.
But there's like, oh my goodness, I'm a writer.
Right. It gives you permission to be in the room. Is what it does.
I know you get some dough for this thing and you can go out for a few nice dinners, but in any other way, you know, I was thinking that, you know, 15, 20 years ago when someone would win a contest like this, agents from New York would be calling and saying, do you have a novel? It's different now. But has it changed professionally the way you move ahead?
It's hard to say. I mean,
partially because
I am so new in this business that when I first won, that was the first thing I worried about was, well, I don't want to drop this ball. Like, it's one thing to have people calling you, which didn't happen.
Yeah.
But I don't want to be the one to have let this moment pass and I didn't, you know, just get off my butt and make something happen from it. So, I don't know. I'm going to do a workshop in February in San Francisco with Tom Jenks at Narrative Magazine.
Yeah.
So that's really nice. Being able to submit my work and have this as part of the submission is good, although I don't know how much that factors in these days when you apply to contests or submit to magazines.
Yeah, I think a contest of this stature still will, it's a nice medal to wear.
And when you're writing an introductory email with your story attached, to be able to say that this isn't it as good. So, but mostly it's about me being serious about my practice, and this was a good step for that, especially.
We got frozen out of this event that was supposed to take place on Monday. You all know what we mean by frozen out. You must have been very, very excited to meet some of the other winners, especially Stuart Dybeck.
Yeah, I was. It would have been fun.
Now you have to go back to that lonely place in California.
Yeah. I have yet to kind of get into the literary community in California. This is a good
sort of entree, I think, to that, because I think this contest is relatively nationally famous. What do you see your future? I know this is really hard. You just won your first award. It came out of nowhere for a short story. I mean, do you see yourself writing in long form?
I think so, and that's more based on how my work feels now. The stories that I'm writing just feel like they want to be longer.
Yeah.
Which could mean they're just longer short stories, or it could mean I need to learn to edit, or it could mean I want to write novels.
What are you doing now? You were one of the great, great legendary waitresses in Chicago's fine dining establishments, and she was here writing short stories. What are you doing out there? What's your straight job these days?
My straight job couldn't be more different in every possible way, is at Pixar. I'm an administrative assistant there.
Really?
That happened really fast after we got to California. I had like a revelation where I applied at a couple restaurants and then decided I was on the floor for this shadow shift. They call it a stage where you go and learn how the restaurant works. And I had this revelation there that I didn't want to.
But it's
that
a nice
anymore.
Thing for a writer even to be in the ground floor job at a place like Pixar.
It's hard to even take in. Yeah, there's so much to. I don't have a creative job, and I likely won't ever have one there. But the place is so creative, and the department I work in is in charge of the education for
oh,
Pixar.
That's great. I can't wait to keep reading whatever. Whatever it is you write.
Thank
and
you.
I'm glad you live in California because you don't have to freeze
yeah,
all winter long.
Yeah, me too. Thank you.
Erika Schmidt, ladies and gentlemen.